Sing praises to God, sing praises. Sing praises to our King, sing praises.
O God, make speed to save us. O Lord, make haste to help us.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Alleluia.
Psalm 68, the first part.
Let God rise and let his enemies be scattered. Let those who hate him flee before him. Let them vanish like smoke when the wind drives it away. As the wax melts at the fire, so let the wicked perish at the presence of God.
But let the righteous be glad and rejoice before God. Let them also be merry and joyful.
Sing to God, sing praises to his name. Exalt him who rides upon the heavens. Yahweh is his name. Rejoice before him.
Father of orphans, defender of widows. God in his holy habitation.
God gives the solitary a home and brings forth prisoners into freedom. But the rebels shall live in dry places.
O God, when you went forth before your people, when you marched through the wilderness,
the earth shook and the skies poured down rain at the presence of God, the God of Sinai. At the presence of God, the God of Israel.
You refreshed the land when it was weak.
is the Lord, by whom we escape death.
God shall crush the heads of his enemies, and the hairy scalp of those who go on still in their wickedness.
The Lord has said, I will bring them back from Bashan. I will bring them back from the depths of the sea,
that your foot may be dipped in blood. The tongues of your dogs in the blood of your enemies.
They see your procession, O God. Your procession into the sanctuary, my God and my King.
The singers go before, musicians follow after. In the midst of maidens playing upon the hand drums.
Bless God in the congregation. Bless the Lord, you that are of the fountain of Israel.
There is Benjamin, east of the tribes of the head, the prince of Judah in a company, and the prince.
from the second book of the Kings, beginning in the second chapter with the first verse. Now when the Lord was about to take Elijah up to heaven by a whirlwind, Elijah and Elisha were on their way from Gilgal. Elijah said to Elisha, "Stay here, for the Lord has sent me as far as Bethel." But Elisha said, "As the Lord lives and as you yourself live, I will not leave you." So they went down to Bethel. The company of prophets who were in Bethel came out to Elisha and said to him, "Do you know that today the Lord will take your master away from you?" And he said, "Yes, I know. Keep silent." Elijah said to him, "Elisha, stay here, for the Lord has sent me to Jericho." But he said, "As the Lord lives, and as you yourself live, I will not leave you." So they came to Jericho. The company of prophets who were at Jericho drew near to Elisha and said to him, "Do you know that today the Lord will take your master away from you?" And he answered, "Yes, I know. Be silent." Then Elijah said to him, "Stay here, for the Lord has sent me to the Jordan." But he said, "As the Lord lives and as you yourself live, I will not leave you." So the two of them went on. 50 men of the company of prophets also went and stood at some distance from them, as they both were standing by the Jordan. Then Elijah took his mantle and rolled it up and struck the water. The water was parted to the one side and to the other until the two of them crossed on dry ground. When they had crossed, Elijah said to Elisha, "Tell me what I may do for you before I am taken from you." Elisha said, "Please let me inherit a double share of your spirit." He responded, "You have asked a hard thing. Yet if you see me as I am being taken from you, it will be granted you. If not, it will not." As they continued walking and talking, a chariot of fire and horses of fire separated the two of them, and Elijah ascended in a whirlwind into heaven. Elisha kept watching and crying out, "Father, Father, the chariots of Israel and its horsemen." But when he could no longer see him, he grasped his own clothes and tore them in two pieces. He picked up the mantle of Elijah that had fallen from him and went back and stood on the bank of the Jordan. He took the mantle of Elijah that had fallen from him and struck the water, saying, "Where is the Lord, the God of Elijah? When he had struck the water was parted to the one side and to the other, and Elisha went over. When the company of prophets who were at Jericho saw him at a distance, they declared, "The spirit of Elijah rests on Elisha." They came to meet him and bowed to the ground before him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Steady. reading from the Revelation to John, beginning in the 5th chapter with the 1st verse. I saw in the right hand of the one seated on the throne a scroll written on the inside and on the back, sealed with 7 seals. And I saw a mighty angel proclaiming with a loud voice, "Who is worthy to open the scroll and break its seals?" And no one in heaven or on earth or under the earth was able to open the scroll or to look into it. And I began to weep bitterly, because no one was found worthy to open the scroll or to look into it. Then one of the elders said to me, "Do not weep. See, the Lion of the tribe of Judah, the Root of David, has conquered, so that he can open the scroll and its 7 seals." Then I saw between the throne and the 4 living creatures and among the elders a lamb standing as if it had been slaughtered, having 7 horns and 7 eyes, which are the 7 spirits of God sent out into all the earth. He went and took the scroll from the right hand of the one who was seated on the throne. When he had taken the scroll, the 4 living creatures and the 24 elders fell before the Lamb, each holding a harp and golden bowls full of incense, which are the prayers of the saints. They sing a new song. "You are worthy to take the scroll and to open its seals. For you were slaughtered, and by your blood you ransomed for God saints from every tribe and language and peoples and nation. You have made them to be a kingdom and priests serving our God, and they will reign on earth." Then I looked and I heard the voice of many angels surrounding the thrones and the living creatures and the elders. They numbered myriads of myriads and thousands of thousands, singing with full voice, "Worthy is the Lamb that was slaughtered to receive power and wealth and wisdom and might and honor and glory and blessing." Then I heard every creature in heaven and on earth and under the earth and in the sea and all that is in them singing, "To the one seated on the throne and to the Lamb, be blessing and honor and might forever and ever." And the 4 living creatures said, "Amen." And the elders fell down and worshiped. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Lord, you now set your servant free to go in peace as you have promised. For these eyes of mine have seen the Savior, whom you have prepared for all the world to see. A light to enlighten the nations, and the glory of
Father in heaven,
hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come.
also in heart and mind thither ascend, and with him continually dwell, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen. Most holy God, the source of all good desires, all right judgments and all just works, give to us your servants that peace which the world cannot give, so that our minds may be fixed on the doing of your will, and that we, being delivered from the fear of all enemies, may live in peace and quietness. Through the mercies of Christ Jesus, our Saviour. Amen. Ye are light in the darkness, O Lord, and in your great mercy defend us from all perils and dangers of this night. For the love of your only Son, our Saviour Jesus Christ.
Amen.
O God and Father of all, whom the whole heavens adore, let the whole earth also worship you, all nations obey you, all tongues confess and bless you, and men and women everywhere love you and serve you in peace, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Let us bless the Lord. Alleluia.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all. Amen.
Amen.